Hello, friends. So I struggle with my mental health. I mean, I've mentioned it before on my channel. You know, you see all my happy vlogs and you see all my story times and you see my TikToks and you see my Instagram. I live such an incredible, beautiful life, and I'm not saying that I don't like it. All of the hurt and like all of the times I've cried like off camera and like those things aren't videoed, and it's not healthy for me to pretend like everything's okay on social media. Talking to this and technically you guys, like my therapy. I don't want to hype this vlog up. I don't want to paint it pretty and perfect. I want to show you something that's real. I know you may not think that this is going to be like a super exciting vlog, a fun vlog, but that's not what's important about this. I'm going back to Missouri. I got a one-way ticket, so I don't know how long I'll be there. I just want to live a little bit and not have to edit it. I have all my stuff packed, and I kid you not, my house is a literal mess. I did start the dishwasher because I didn't want that to stink while I was gone. Mom angle. Let's go get our mental health on. I made it to Kansas City, Missouri. I'm vlogging on my phone because my anxiety says that I'm not taking my camera out. We made it. I've also never vlogged on my phone before, so I'm not entirely sure how this is gonna look. Magic spell you cast. This is love your roses. It's been one day. I've literally just slept and cried on my parents' couch.
Hey guys, look at that. She's off the couch. I'm going to go get coffee at my favorite coffee shop. I thought it was super funny because in one of my past videos, I was at the coffee shop and I drank it and I was like, oh my gosh, this coffee could cure depression. And it's just funny because now I am sad and I'm gonna go drink it. Let's just go see if the coffee still cures depression. I'm gonna listen to some worship music because I freaking need it. Yeah, I'll see you at the coffee shop.
Well, there's blue in the sky every day, but all they wanna see.
Okay, so I just went into the gas station. Of course, my luck is that my card wouldn't work out here, so I had to go inside and use the card inside. And I was in there and I was like, I just don't feel like socializing with literally anyone. And she's like, hey Tabby, how are you? And I was like, I'm not gonna cry. Literally, I'm not gonna cry in a freaking gas station. I draw the line at crying in public. And then my eyes started to get watery and she goes, oh, never mind. I was like, okay, all right, I am falling apart. So you know how sometimes like you shouldn't laugh at something whenever you see it happen? Well, I was just pulling into the coffee shop and I just saw a kid swerving around on his bike and he just fell off and I laughed. Okay, so I just went to the coffee shop and I asked her like which one I should get. She's like, one has ice cream in it and then the other has protein in it, but like they're both really good. And I was like, you know freaking what, I'll just take both of them. So I just got two. This one's the Merv Harry S. Truman. I just have so much anxiety. Anytime I put something in my body, I just feel like I have to throw up. Ugh, gosh, dude. I made plans with my friends over the next couple of days, but like truthfully, I don't want to do anything. All I want to do is just lay on my parents' couch and do absolutely nothing.
Well, there's blue in the sky every day.
Okay, so I'm on a walk and I'm walking by cows and check them out.
Is the gray. And I see beauty.
When you have no friends, so you try to make friends with the neighbor cow. Walk is killing me, but it's nice. But until it's actually really pretty too. They don't have time.
What they want to see.
In love. No deal. Bet you guys didn't know I lived on a farm. Come here. Okay, now I'm going to go help my dad with his truck. If this isn't the most country hillbilly outfit you've ever seen in your life. Wait, hang on. Dad has the Asics 280 dad shoes. My Nike socks on his feet.
No, I don't. We're painting, come on.
We're painting his truck.
Okay. It's hot, so we gotta hurry.
This is the type of mask you have to wear during COVID. This is really freaking hot.
I don't wanna fall asleep, I don't wanna pass away. I've been thinking of our future cause I'll never see the place. I don't know why this has happened, but I probably deserve it.
I'm trying not to get high. Love you, bye. Ew. My dad told me to cover my face so that I didn't get high because of that. And you know, I'm not saying I'm a little high, but look who's greeting me at the door. Oh my gosh.
Hi, today's like what, day 3? I woke up at 9 a.m. and then I was like, what's the purpose? So like I went back to sleep and now it's 2:45 and I woke up and I'm still like, what's the purpose? Going back to the coffee shop, just, I don't know. All I want to do is sleep, that's it. I'm making myself leave, and making myself leave for coffee, I guess, is a way of getting out. Today I got a lemonade. You know what, I just realized it's not like the coffee that like makes you feel better at all. Like going to the coffee shop doesn't make you feel better, but it's literally this freaking community. Everyone knows everyone. I just love coming back to this community and literally just feeling like love, even though some people probably still hate me from high school. Anyways, I went to the coffee shop and one of my friend's moms worked there. Compton, shout out to you. But anyways, she like genuinely wants to have a conversation with you, and she just like genuinely cares. I'm going to visit my mom right now. Talk to my mom, that's nice. Now I'm gonna go see one of my coaches from high school. Also gonna see one of my best friends, her name is Mary.
I changed. I got it. This is like so something I would have worn in high school. Anyways, let's go.
Pretty much the story on why I'm going to the weight room. Some of you guys know, some of you don't know. If you don't know, I used to struggle with an eating disorder in high school, like middle school and high school, but like no one knew about it till high school. No one knew about it except for my counselor. I used to always care about my weight and just always want to be skinny in high school. I was looking at the records and one of the coaches, they were like, you'd never be able to break a record. And I was like, you're gonna bet? Yes, I freaking can. And so then he pretty much just like encouraged me all year to like break this record and stuff. Worked really, really hard and I ended up breaking the deadlift record. I used to do like weightlifting and stuff in high school. I'm also gonna go see my friend Mary, who I haven't seen in like a year. Her and I were literally sisters. Like she used to live with me and everything. Like we used to be super, super close. Okay, I haven't seen Mary in a whole year and now I get to see her. She's right there. Get out of your car.
My car's a piece of crap.
Oh my gosh, dude.
You're freaking forever.
Okay, Coach Lundeen just said that Mary and I will both be engaged 6 months from now. He's making a bet. He's betting on it. So, all right, let's shake. I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding.
Me and Mary are finally back in the weight room.
Yeah.
Do you think that if we were to go double plate 300, do you think we still deadlift 300?
We can try.
Yeah, I bet we could do it.
I don't want to fall asleep. I don't want.
I'm not gonna die, but we're gonna try.
This is just 35.
Because I'll never see those days. I don't know why this has happened, but I probably deserve it. I tried to do my best, but you know that.
Weird.
Okay, we did that and now we're gonna attempt to power clean.
I don't want
to
fall asleep. I don't want to pass away. I've been.
Mary and I are peacing out. We have to say our goodbyes. Okay, so I'm leaving the weight room now. I freaking love talking to Lundeen, and it was literally so good to see Mary. I just feel so much better. You have no idea. Now I'm going to go home, and I'm going to go have dinner with my grandpa. My grandpa has cancer. He's not doing too hot right now. That's why we're going to his house, so we're going to bring him dinner and just, like, hang out with him. I haven't seen my grandpa in a little while. I'm excited to go see him now. I'm pumped. Oh, and by the way, someone did break my record, so I no longer have the deadlift record, so there's that. Dad, I'm gonna get copyrighted.
I thought you said that you know how to edit that out or something.
You can't just edit the music out.
I thought you could cover it up.
Yes, but you can't do that like that. It's still in the... Okay, my dad and I are gonna go take my grandpa Chicken Mary's.
Chicken Mary's.
Chicken Mary's now.
Nation's number one fried chicken.
That's really KFC.
No, it's not. Chicken Mary's, number one.
Dad, people don't even know.
It was on the Food Network, I promise you.
Oh my God.
I promise.
My grandpa has fish in his house. I feel like a child. We're going on a walk. Look, Max. Come here. Hey, look. Ah! Okay, we're taking the dogs on a walk.
Hi. I'm putting in my vlog, so smile. Make it look like we're being social.
I fly across the US and Nancy doesn't even give me attention and she's on her phone. Nancy's my sister. I'm just kidding, she's my stepmom. She just looks younger than I do, that's all. Because she is, because my dad's into younger women.
Stop!
Just kidding.
What is wrong with
she's
you?
25.
Nancy and I are down 1 mile.
Inside, and though I close my eyes, I see love you.
Hi. Okay, so it's currently...
What time is it?
It's 9:04!
That's the earliest I've been up.
That there's a kid walking down the street. And this kid kind of looks like my brother. Okay, that's 100% my brother.
What?
Why is my brother walking down the road by himself holding a pillow? Why is my life like this? Why is my life like this?
What the heck is he doing?
What are you doing?
Spend the night at my friend's house.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. What I was going to say is today I learned that you shouldn't put all of your faith and trust in anything worldly or any human being because they are bound to let you down. Just think of how many times you've messed up in your life. Anyways, that's what I learned today. Guys, guess where I'm going? Yep, we're getting coffee. Secured the bag. That was a really unflattering noise, and I am incredibly sorry for that. I texted my mom, and I asked my mom if she wanted to go get lunch with me, and she hasn't responded to me. That's okay, though, because it is only 9 a.m. So apparently no one wants to hang out with me. I texted everyone 15 minutes ago, and not one soul has replied. I just drank this so fast, I almost just threw up. I'm going on a second outing. I'm sure you're like, Tabitha, where are you going? I'm going out to eat with my mom. Ow, something's stabbing my stomach. Ow, 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 ow. Ow, ow. You know what gives me anxiety? Eating at restaurants in my hometown. I know 100% I'm bound to walk into someone I know. I don't know why, it just gives me this crazy amount of anxiety. I haven't seen a lot of these people in like 2 years. A lot of people hate me. A lot of people don't talk to me. And then like some of them DM me sometimes, even though I thought they hated me. And then it's just like really confusing. So then you walk in and they're like, hey. And then you're like, oh my gosh, like I thought you didn't like me. And then you say, hey. And then like they get those weird vibes like, oh crap, like she's socially awkward. And then like, you just don't know what to do. You know what I'm saying? No, just me? All right.
Oh my gosh.
I was gonna show you my food, but then I forgot to aesthetically take a picture of it. Yeah, this is what's left. Wait, I don't even know why you guys freaking watch my stuff. Blake,
what?
You go potty outside? You go outside? You go potty outside? Go outside?
Stop.
Go outside? I thought you need to go potty.
Well, there's blue in the sky every day.
Okay, so every time I start vlogging again, I swear I'm in a different outfit. In reality, I just change 4 times a day. Say, hypothetically, if you were to guess where I was gonna go hang out with my friends at, what would you say? A coffee shop. You're right. You're right. You know how I just said I was going to a coffee shop? Well, on the way to the coffee shop we're meeting at, I had to take a detour because I just stopped at the coffee shop in my little tiny town. It's a protein shake. Okay, so Kara, Caitlin, and Michelle and I are all at Texas Roadhouse. And Caitlin found a keeper. And by keeper, I mean a boy. A very fine boy. Okay?
Very.
And so she's taking her shot with writing her phone number on a we won't show that. On a napkin. On a napkin. Anyways, we're pretending like her name is Tay, and Kara's gonna walk past and drop it off at the boy's table. He's with his grandparents, so he seems wholesome. Do you think that this is love?
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
No,
yeah.
You should.
Oh yeah. We just keep making eye contact and it's love.
Dude, hey, should I just do it now?
Do it. Do it.
Say my friend once. This is really. No, you should. He doesn't know who it is.
All right, she's going. Life is so crazy and unpredictable. Sometimes you just feel like you can't get a freaking break. Literally, I went to bed last night thinking, wow, everything's getting better. Everything just feels okay. I just found out that my grandpa passed away. Life just decided to hit me with a bunch of curveballs, I guess. Ironically, we literally just went to go see my grandpa 2 days ago. I guess there's a reason why I came back home. I would get the opportunity to say goodbye to my grandpa. Knowing that I got to see him before makes me feel better. So, yeah. Life is just a little tough right now. But as my grandpa would always say, no worries.
My grandpa made me promise him that whenever he passed away, I wouldn't cry. Sorry, Grandpa. But I freaking lied. And cancer had nothing on it. I will forever remind myself of no worries because my grandpa found peace in that phrase. He found peace in knowing that the battle was God and that he was commanded only to be still. My grandpa served our country. He served everyone around him and he served God. And now it's his turn to rest. And as my grandpa would say, no worries.
The last couple of days have been pretty tough since my grandpa passed away. Obviously, he wouldn't want us to be upset, and instead, he would want us to celebrate. Spent the last couple of days just like reminiscing, talking about his life and stuff. We went mini golfing with family.
I like mine.
Now we're going to Life Church as a family, which I'm super, super excited about. And then I think that we're going to go play Top Golf afterwards. And I've never done that before, so that'll be fun. But yeah, we're taking the days as they come. Change of plans. We're going to, where are we going?
Bass Pro.
We're going to the Bass Pro shop.
This is my parents. That's Nancy.
Nancy, why are you taking your pants off? One day, I decided to stop before a really, really big hill on the highway. And whenever I did, I had to stop because I started my period and I wanted to change my pants. So I had to change my pants before I was gonna go like meet friends or whatever. And a police officer, highway patrolman, whatever, pulls up next to me and we make dead eye contact with my naked bare butt in my seat. The man ran away because he knew what he saw was not appropriate. And so he waited until I was changed and then I flagged him. And then he came to my window and he was just like, hey. And I was like, look, I can explain. I was already crying. And he's like, I was pulling you over because you pulled off on the side of the road in a no safe zone.
You came home crying.
And I came home crying.
What did your dad tell you to do? Your dad said, make a video about it.
Oh yeah, my dad said, make a video about it and post it on TikTok, and I did.
And people will understand and relate.
And people would think it's funny. And I posted it on TikTok and it was one of my most viral videos.
I said, you're crying now, but someday you will
laugh about it. My dad is in his boxers in the parking lot. My dad is streaking in the parking lot. To be completely honest, I don't know what's happening. And then my stepmom is carrying a basket in the parking lot. At Topgolf. And people ask me why my life is so crazy. This is why. What the frick is this? This is not normal. It's a virgin something. I don't know what it is, but it's virgin. Back to Pensacola I go. My sister's half asleep. She's not even functioning correctly. My dad needed food so that he could function.
You got food too. Correctly.
Yeah, I got food too. Okay, I'm saying goodbye.
Goodbye. Love you.
Oh. Love you, bye. Kiss my head like that.
Thank you.
So my friend Hannah and I went to get acai bowls and then I came home. And then I literally slept from 10:15 until 5:30. I just wanted to say, if you made it this far into the video, wow, you really made it a long ways. And to thank you for watching my video and just going along on my realistic vlog life. Recently, life has been throwing me a lot of curveballs, but instead of pretending like everything's fine in my vlogs and on social media, I decided that I would just show you guys how it really is. You guys are great. You guys are awesome. Sometimes life is hard, but you and I, we're in this together. Be sure to subscribe, drop a hate comment, follow me on my other social media platforms, specifically Instagram, and I will see you guys next week. Handshake. Bye.
I don't wanna fall asleep, I don't wanna pass away. I've been thinking of our future, cause I'll never see those days. I don't know why this has happened, but I probably deserve it. I tried to do my best, but I don't wanna fall asleep, I don't wanna pass away. I've been thinking of our future, cause I'll never see those days. I don't know why this has happened, but I probably deserve it. I tried to do my best, but you know that